Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. MashaAllah, it's really a great feeling to be here at the premiere screening of our Hajj documentary, The People of the South, Hajj 1440-2019. The spirits are high. We have past Hujjaj, prospective Hujjaj for this year, as well as people who just came to be inspired and family members and friends. And subhanAllah, what we hope and pray for this documentary is not only to showcase the culture of South Africans, but also to inspire, educate, and motivate future Hujjaj to us to know what the reality of Hajj is all about. Bismillah ta'ala. So we're all excited, we're ready to go in and to watch this documentary. We make dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us tawfiq and make it a successful event. Jazakumullah khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
In the footsteps of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Hujjaj are now prepared to say their final farewells and salutations.
And I think it's true what Mullah Irshad said, and I think he and myself, we speak on behalf of everybody. The emotions were so high now, subhanAllah. We're so close to tears. Just the thing that Allah has granted us the honor to be on Arafah, to be on Mina, to be in front of the Baytullah, to be with Rasulullah, and the list just goes on, Allahu Akbar. And exactly what Imam Yusuf Pandey said on the screen, may Allah grant us, after we came back from Arafah, that we will hold on to the rope of Allah, and be close to Allah, be close to Rasulullah, because we have been given the guarantee to Jannah on Arafah. We just need to hold on to the guarantee. And as you know, that I always remind you on Mina, on Arafah, everywhere, the five times Salah. It's almost, I can say, it is unacceptable that after you've been forgiven on the day of Arafah, that you are again being neglectful of the Salah. And I'm sure none of the Hujjaj, but if one or two of you have been neglectful of the Salah, tonight brought you back these memories and you can reaffirm to make that five times Salah every day, inshallah. May Allah grant us, as we've been together on Arafah and on Mina and here tonight, may Allah grant us to be together in Jannah.
Subhanallah, alhamdulillah, a journey of a lifetime. Allah has honored and Allah has blessed us to be the Hujjaj of 1440, subhanallah. And an honor tonight, it felt like we back in Makkatul Mukarramah and Madinatul Munawwara. And subhanallah, watching our documentary felt like standing on Arafah all over, and Muzdalifah, and Mina, and alhamdulillah, all the Hujjaj as well tonight bring us together. Subhanallah, it's a different feeling. Allahu Akbar. And we want to tell all the Hujjaj of 1441, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala facilitate all your matters. Alhamdulillah, we traveled with the Algerian team, an excellent team, a dedicated team to the Hujjaj, and a team that will look and facilitate all your matters bi-idhnillah, with the kudrat and the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Shukran. Assalamu alaikum.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Sheikh, I just want to say the narration that you did on the DVD brought so much emotion. Alhamdulillah, we really loved everything. And I just want to say to the Algerian team, shukran, shukran, shukran. Because they made our Hajj so special. I couldn't have asked for a better Hajj. Alhamdulillah. Allahu Akbar, everything was amazing. Shukran for doing this documentary. I just brought all that emotion back again, and it felt like I was there, standing on Arafah again. You just brought all the memories and emotion back. Alhamdulillah, shukran so much. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Assalamu alaikum. It's an awesome experience. It's taking you back, reminiscing about your Hajj. It brings your longing back to go to Makkah. Shukran to the Al-Zim team for this, and it's a very good thing. Alhamdulillah.
Assalamu alaikum. I just want to say shukran to Al-Zim. That was an absolutely fantastic documentary. Shukran, Maulana Irshad. I cried several times throughout that. I basically relive my Hajj tonight. And all the doubts you had, you know, coming out of your Hajj, did you do enough? And tonight, reliving that, you can say, Alhamdulillah, I did enough. So shukran for allowing me that opportunity again.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Sure, that was very emotional. Took me right back to every day of Hajj. Reliving the whole experience was so beautiful. Actually still quite feeling jittery and shaky completely emotional reliving that day of Arafah, subhanAllah. I could like actually feel myself standing there with the rain just gushing all over me, soaking wet, washing all that dust off, literally and figuratively, alhamdulillah. It's very beautiful to relive and see all again.
Barakallah, just one question. You guys had the full stay, if I remember correctly, you remained in
Makkah. Alhamdulillah, yes.
Tell us, what was your experience like compared to having to move out of Makkah away from the Haram? How did you experience Abraj in the full stay?
I wouldn't want to ever have moved away from the Kaaba. Going to Makkah is to be close to the Kaaba. It's the only place in the world where you can form that kind of ibadah to make tawaf around Allah's Baytullah. So being there and close by, having access to the Kaaba every day was just beautiful. And even from Abraj, I had my reservations, wanting to stay in the front line. Obviously, it's not possible, but Abraj was actually so accessible. Despite the heat and not being super fit, a walk down to the Haram wasn't that hard. It was quite leisurely. Back is a bit of a challenge, but getting there is no problem.
Did you have any friends or other fellow Hujjaj who were staying in Aziziyah, and how did you experience this compared to these?
So from chatting them, it was quite challenging for them to actually get into Makkah, especially after the 4th of Dhul Hijjah. It was actually impossible. They were coming in quite late in the evenings, maybe just so they could get that glimpse of the Kaaba, but many days they didn't even actually get into Makkah because the roads were just so congested. So I felt privileged.
Tell me, for future Hujjaj, people who haven't been in Hajj, would you recommend that they watch this documentary? What do you think they'll get out of it?
Definitely. Just a clarity about logistics, and seeing Mina, seeing Muzdalifah, seeing the Jamarat, it actually gives you a better visual of what to expect. And I definitely would prepare, definitely see it.
The feeling watching the documentary is fantastic. That's why I came. I wanted to see all my brothers and sisters I was on Hajj with. It's amazing. And I need to actually say the most important thing for me is the initiative that has been taken by Algeria to do a program like this, or to run a project like this. It's fantastic. But inshallah, maybe again my time will come to again, and without a shadow of a doubt, my choice will be Algeria. Shukran.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I just want to congratulate one and all for putting this wonderful documentary together. It's very insightful, very educational, and it also gives prospective Hujjaj an idea of what it's all about. I think it's long overdue. Alhamdulillah, finally made it. And I can't even begin to tell you the amount of nerves that was touched tonight, reliving every moment of that documentary. Brought back so much good memories, alhamdulillah. And I'd just like to wish all the prospective Hujjaj well in their preparations. Ameen.
Maulana, for me, all I can say is we should have more of these tear-jerking movie night events, subhanAllah. Forget about Bollywood, forget about Hollywood. This is the real deal. This is what people need to see. This is where people want to reminisce about their Hajj, subhanAllah. Just seeing the response from not only our Hujjaj that traveled last year, the potential Hujjaj, family and friends that I've seen here tonight that is awaiting accreditation, I think the message has really gone home. The interest is there really to fulfill this ibadat. And this event for me, alhamdulillah, all I can say is this Algeem team, the sky's the limit. This is just another one on top of that. And there's still more to come. So, Sheikh Hassan, you have missed a phenomenal event tonight. SubhanAllah, Allah bless you for your efforts, for your perseverance. And then maybe there's a reason why you were not supposed to be here, because the stars of this evening was really the Hujjaj of 2019, subhanAllah. So alhamdulillah, for each and every one, I can say the Algeem team, Maulana Irshad, Sheikh Hassan, Muhammad Ashraf, Imam Pandi, everybody behind the scenes, really, this footage is absolutely beautiful. We should continue with all this work year on, year out, with every group. It is absolutely beautiful to just sit and reminisce about your Hajj over and over. Alhamdulillah. Shukran.